Responding to every serious fire in Manhattan since 1915, Rescue 1 attracted the finest men in the department. Assigned a 59 B-model Mack with a Gerstenslager body, Rescue 1 shared quarters with 65 engine in the classic firehouse on West 43rd between 5th and 6th Avenues. Dozens of bright, ambitious young men served on the rescue, and then, following the example of John McElligott, rose through the ranks. Appointed the first captain of Rescue 1 by Chief Kenlon, McElligott became chief when Kenlon retired. The watch desk was on the first floor and was continuously manned when the companies were in quarters. Working in 3-hour shifts, the man on watch logged every alarm on the blackboard and in the journal. He also called out the response. The bunk room occupied the second floor, and the third floor housed the day room and the captain's office. The engine companies were stretching in, and the truck companies were opening up as the rescue company arrives. There are reports of persons trapped, and Rescue 1 is ordered to find them and get them out. An elderly woman is found unconscious in her apartment. Their job completed, the rescue strikes in service. Little luck. Dinner will be on the table before the next call.
Rescue goes!
Tonight, however, the gods are laughing, not smiling. Dinner may be on the table, but the men of Rescue 1 are on their way to another fire. As they have done 1,000 times before, the men of the rescue respond into the night and again prepare to battle the demon, glowing in the distance.